that's many. We back to the niggas, man. Back to the niggas, man.
I like him. I like this guy. This guy is real.
He's all right.
I like this guy now because he reminds me of being back in 89.
You should feel
with him.
Back in
89. I think you said something. You said, goddamn, I'll knock you off. I heard that. Bam! I'm at work. Don't sit down. Motherfucker, I told you, nigga. Don't play me about
my young spirit, huh?
Nah, don't play me about my savior. You know, and I just got delivered. I'm a crazy relationship while I'm fucking with a witch.
They said a witch.
So, yeah, man. Man, I had a dream, right? And in this dream, my woman in the car with two chicks.
You can't move over there and get the vote.
No further on. They turned the
voices. I can't get the voices. Right, I have to stand on the
I'm
sign.
Like, uh-oh.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I went to the house. The table full of gold, silver. I picked it up when it fell with stickers and
that's the people. That's representative of the people. Bones is a people that are spiritually dead. That's spiritually dead. You know, they don't know what way to go. They don't know up from down, right from left, funky from clean.
They all dried up.
You know, they don't know nothing, man.
I'm gonna give you something. I can't run with it, but the one-eyed man is king in the land of blind.
Right.
Hold on. The one-eyed man is king in the land of the blind. So, who that means,
right. Brother with the deep, dark sayings. My man.
If a person come with a little bit of truth and you lack of it, they gonna grab it. Because they ain't had none. You're leaving somewhere that ain't there before.
That's why we gotta come out here.
Exactly, man. Do whatever you put in your heart, you soldiers. Because I know when I see them, I'm accountable for everything I do. So, I'm gonna let that be said. Every choice, every decision made. It's like, one time it's a snake, second time it's a decision.
That's true, too. You know, people don't want to be corrected anyway. And they don't want to change their way, especially if they practicing this shit for years and years and years. An old fool don't want to get what's the difference between the old man, old people that just can't accept new wine?
Yeah, you can't throw an old wine back with new wine that'll burst open and explode.
You know, they used to that old, what's that cheap wine we always mentioned?
Oh, they've been sipping on that old Wild Irish Road.
Wild Irish Road. I don't know why I can never remember that.
We drinking that good shit, man. Right. Age. They sipping on the old Wild Irish. They drinking Mad Dog.
Right.
While we
let
sipping
me try
on.
Find it.
Yeah, we sipping on that nice one. Yeah. I got a scripture for him. To talk dealing with our people. Jeremiah 2:21. Actually, I'm going to start at Jeremiah 2:19. This is dealing with our people. Thine own wickedness shall correct thee, and thy backsliding shall reprove thee.
Yeah.
Know therefore and see that it is an evil thing and bitter that thou hast forsaken the Lord thy God, and that my fear is not in thee, save the Lord God of hosts. For of old time I have broken thy yoke and burst thy bands, and thou sayest, I will not transgress. When upon every high hill and under every green tree thou wanderest, playing the harlot. Because our people, they committing whoredoms against the Lord. You know what I'm saying?
They spiritual kind of shit.
Yeah, they play the whore.
Defiled by women. Defiled by women. Yeah. Those women represent all kind of philosophy.
Yeah.
Wicked shit.
Yeah, because our people are infested with spiritual STDs. You know what I mean? And physical. He said, yet I planted thee a noble vine, wholly a right seed. How then art thou turned into the degenerate plant of a strange vine unto me? Right? Because the Lord first planted us. We supposed to be the Israel, the Lord's chosen people. But now everybody turned into a bunch of degenerates. Everybody's all retarded, all degenerate, filthy.
Everybody's striving to be a snake.
Yeah, a snake. That's what's hot, is to be a slithering snake. To be
evil.
Wickedness prevails out here. That's all you see out here is wickedness. There ain't none to do with good.
None.
None. No, not one.
None.
Right.
Why do you think I don't go nowhere? Why do you think I can't go nowhere, man? If I do go somewhere, see some woods or some near water with a lot of people in that, man.
That's crazy.
Because you don't know what these people going to do behind you, man.
Nah.
You don't know what's going to crack in their head. So many times you hear on the news, somebody just snaps, man.
And you hear they just found a dead body floating in the Scioto. Shit. That was just a couple days ago. Someone just, and they said it wasn't from drowning. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, where I grew up at, what's the road, they found two bodies in the woods where I be running and walking, taking my dog and shit. They found two bodies, and they just now identified the bones, because one body was all bones. And they just finally identified who the motherfucker was. A nigga, of course. You don't know what these people going to do, man. I mean, they just... This is it.
They gotta find this scripture. What's that? They unbalanced. What's that word? They definitely off balance. These motherfuckers are unstable. You know what I'm saying? They got no stability. They got all them demons all up in them, just making them act all crazy and wild and shit.
Ecclesiastes 20:1. There is a reproof that is not comely. Again, some man holdeth his tongue, and he is wise. It is much better to reprove than to be angry secretly, and he that confesseth his fault shall be preserved from hurt.
Yeah, because sometimes a fool becomes wise when he shuts the hell up and don't talk. Instead of coming up here scoffing.
Don't know what he's saying.
Don't know what he says. Yeah, he becomes wise when he just keeps his mouth shut and listens. You know what I mean? Where did Nate's people go? Yeah, you see where they went?
Right there by the stop.
We might have to go talk to them.
They visit.
That's funny they was out here. They looked all lost. They look like lost sheep wandering around. You know, they was all... They look like they was all scared walking around.
Yeah, they stopped when they saw us too. They literally stopped right there. They just stopped because they was coming here. And they couldn't even come and be like brother. That just showed you they ain't brother.
Oh, brothers, you should be excited about. Oh, you out here teaching too.
Right. And the scripture says to be brotherly. You know, it's to be brotherly. The scripture always is stressing for being brotherly, man.
Yeah. You're supposed to be brotherly.
Got them snakes and fools and goblins. He's all right, bro.
Oh, he's good.
He's all right. Sometimes, like. Where's that one at? Oh, there it is.
Oh, you can stop all over that one.
You see that white jeans?
Oh, yeah.
Go step and get you a blessing,
man. Go jump on him.
We're crushing those images. We're crushing those images.
Hey, the scriptures do say you're supposed to burn them images with fire. Really? Why does mine be the good thing?
Yeah. Oh, good looking, bro.
Go ahead, reread.
Should run that number.
How good is it when thou art reproved? People might be reproved.
Yeah, you reprove somebody, that actually could start a fight.
Is that Proverbs you're reading? Okay.
Make sure you read loud, louder. You gotta let tell your voice.
Ecclesiastes 4. 3. How good is it when thou art reproved to show repentance? For so shalt thou escape willful sin.
Yeah, because our people willfully sin. They don't be doing it on accident. They know what they're doing. They are cold, calculated adulterers. Wait, they just looking out the window blind. Oh, husband's gone. Time to go over.
Yep, because they're taking that grace to an extreme.
Yep.
Playing it wrong. Look at the wrong
moms.
Grace don't mean go do it. Shit. Finish with that one. Proverbs 3:11. My son, despise not the chastity of the Lord. Was this one read already? Neither be worried of his correction. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even as a father the son in whom he delighteth. Happy is the man that findeth wisdom, and the man that gathereth understanding.
That's the only happiness you're going to get out here in this hellhole, that wisdom and understanding. That's the only thing that's going to hold you down. I got
to appreciate it. Find answers to why all this shit is happening. You find answers to why you're struggling. Find answers to why your family's broken up. You find answers to everything.
I don't know how people can survive without this wisdom.
Right. That's the key. That's the key.
That's why everybody's so damn miserable. You know what I'm saying? They got no knowledge, no wisdom, no truth.
This is all the answers to why.
So that's why we all live in a filth. Yeah, I got a scripture. But I got a precept for that. Isaiah 33:6. Actually, I'm going to start at 5. Isaiah 33:5. The Lord is exalted, for he dwelleth on high. He hath filled Zion with judgment and righteousness. And wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time. And the strength of salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. I know that scripture.
You talking my language, man. You talking my language.
Yeah, I know.
You talking my language. Break it down. They don't know you're supposed to break the scripture down.
Yeah.
You're supposed to be edification. You know what
I'm saying? He must have been an Israelite back when the 1990 Israelite.
89. Like remember, he said he reminded me of 89.
But everybody had got their glory.
Like when I first found out I was a Jew. Was Farrakhan, right?
Yeah.
But here in Columbus, there's an actual dude I grew up with, some younger dude too. He's like, we Jews, man, we Jews, you know? And it was kind of hot, it was kind of a tradition, and I ignored it.
Yeah.
I went on my wicked ass life, you know? But it was like it was a trend, and then it faded out. You know, you see the same dudes now, they ain't into none of it, you know? They into the world in prison, homosexual, sodomites, or whatever, you know?
Yeah, but now you're doing something right.
Yeah.
And people find us in the spirit world. Making a trip to offset what you guys are doing.
Right, right.
The Caesar Borgia thing, you know, everybody knows now, it's become common knowledge, that it's not something we do to self-exalt, you know.
Right, right.
In the word, like, if no lines blurred, believers of all nations, if you come unto God, let's get in the word, man. Let's edify, because I see you guys back here, and I see a lot of brothers out here preaching the word.
Out here downtown?
Yeah. And
probably a lot of confusion.
It's confusion.
Confusion.
Proverbs 21:2 says, every way in a man's heart is right, but God pondereth your intentions. If your intentions are impure, to speak on the gospel.
That's what we was talking about.
We was just talking about right before you came up. See, we ain't out here bringing confusion. We out here bringing the truth.
Right.
See how
you live on raggedy. Look at this dude down.
They're more on the carnal side of things.
It's funny because I remember trying to make more. You people don't understand what I'm saying, but
what?
Tribesmen, Peter, Judah, Joseph, Reuben.
They're right there.
And it says they're scattered upon the four corners of the earth. It's more complex than knowing exactly who somebody is.
Well, we don't know that.
Exactly.
But we do know it through the Spirit, though.
Through the Spirit.
Through the Spirit. So we do know. We don't know exactly. When you first might meet somebody, you got to touch their spirit.
Yeah.
You know, see how they act. You know what I'm saying? See how they conduct themselves. And then even through the Spirit, you can even tell what tribe someone was from just by the characteristics.
Never lose their characteristics. The Lord don't change nothing. It's bad, too. It's bad.
He's bad. I like you, brothers. You know why? Because it looks like you seek to agree. You find agreement first.
Get that?
Titus 3:10 is another precept of agreement as well. Remembering where you were, to know that everybody needs the grace of God.
Yeah.
That's bad.
And it there's not one person except says that he does not wish that none should perish. None. None. None.
Even though they will.
He doesn't wish that none should perish. Another piece of Jeremiah 29, 11, 13. You know, when he goes on to talk to Quack, paraphrase, I don't want to misappropriate the word.
Yeah.
But you know, he knows our wants, man. And then we have, then it's just comparison. I'm just offering things I know, brothers. You know, I don't want to compare and I don't want to compete. But I thought it was good that I see you guys back here. The comparison of the scriptures, 1 Corinthians chapter 10. Hopefully you guys can keep that to me, you know. Different parts
what
of
did you got to bring out?
Yeah. Oh, go ahead, go ahead.
Oh, that's how the word does you, though.
Yeah, yes, sir.
You know, you start bringing the word out, and all kind of scriptures start blasting in your mind.
A lot of them dudes,
they can't understand about Israel being scattered.
Good name.
Yeah, that's a stumbling block.
Yeah, they don't understand the mystery of the Gentiles and all that. You know, they don't understand about how Israel scattered.
For example, like them fools right there, they see these, they're Edomites automatically. They're already naturally devil because they look like us, you know.
They probably would say that. You know?
Oh, of course they would. They ain't nothing spiritual about them. They're carnally minded, man.
Yeah.
You know, you see the videos on the YouTube all the time. The white boys in your camp. Not just this camp, there's other camps. A couple of so-called white dudes in their camp. They no devils, the devil. Why you got Esau in your camp?
It's funny because when God is chastising and the scriptures about chastising the nations that have done wrong, we have no hand in that. Funny, because all nations have made choices and got cursed because of it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Israel is like one of the top wicked nations. Israel is the king of wickedness.
You gotta come up to speed because Israel's gathered. I have both sides of my family, you know, different tribes.
Yeah.
But
there's a very small percentage of Israel, though. First of all, that knows they Israel and actually.
We're on the same page.
You know what I'm saying? But actually tries to do the right thing. They teach them brothers. Most of our people look at it and they're like savages.
There's 7 mortal tribesmen in my family.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. And you know what I mean when I say that. Four of whom are part of the Holy Spirit.
Well, why'd you say mortal? Because we're actually all immortals.
Except for tribesmen.
How's that?
The tribesmen, Judah, Joseph, Reuben, Issachar, are earth babies.
Yeah, we're all immortal. The Lord got preached everlasting life.
You know what I mean? That's why you're laughing. But the whole thing is this. Nobody talks on these things. They don't speak on it because everybody wants to have this Marsha complex and comparison. But God doesn't love the older child more than the younger child or the younger child more than the older child. The problem is that people get hurt thinking that he shows a certain favor because he chose them to do a certain function. It's not for us to be bashing one another.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, what he did is he walked out the house.
But sometimes you got to, though.
Well, yeah, for chastity.
It's all about balance, you know?
Yeah.
You gotta be balanced.
So he walked out the house and he left the older child
in
charge of the younger child. Right? Let me give you guys a parable. Like, he walked out of the house, he gave the older child care over the younger child. And then he watched to see what the older child would do. The older child was supposed to teach the younger child how to ride a bike, right? As angels. Supposed to teach the younger child how to be diligent, supposed to be an example of God.
Well,
and the older children have dropped the ball for Israel.
Well, Esau was the oldest. He was the elder. But he didn't get the blessing. It was Jacob that got
it. He made a choice.
Let me read this real quick. This is Isaiah 58:1. Cry aloud, spare not. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet and show my people their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sins.
So, I know, especially, see today, I know what you're saying when you're supposed to be the brotherly spirit. We're supposed to be trying to show love to brothers, right? But then at the same time, you got some wicked demons out here perverting the gospel, teaching some crazy stuff that they ought not to be teaching. Then you got to say something to them.
Right. You know, it says here, cry loud and spare not. You know? And they're going to be...
And that's where you get a lot of the contention from, though. Yeah, you know what I mean?
The sore spots. What happens is we touch a part they don't want to deal with within themselves.
Yeah.
And in Job 5:17, it says, blessed are those whom God corrects who do not despise the chastisement of the Almighty. Precept to that would be Proverbs 12:1. A man who loves knowledge goes with correction. A man who does not
destroy.
And then the 15, you know, you come under wise counsel. And that, now the problem with that is everybody is still beefing with one another, trying to exalt themselves above others.
Everybody won't be
there's
the top
examples like that, which with people who close to them, you know, all kind of all the examples of right now is in the Bible.
Is that one scripture cuts a lot of them guys?
They hate it.
When you read that scripture, the first shall be last, and the last shall be first. Them dudes, they don't want to deal with that. You know what I mean?
Touch a sore spot.
Because they, you know, they want to exalt themselves.
It touches a part of conviction that they haven't applied. Now, you can read the word, but if you're not applying
them. Oh, yeah, you ain't heard about the governing body of Israel? The new.
It's a bunch of brothers coming. So they're not even brothers because they don't agree on everything. But it's a bunch of people coming together that don't agree on everything. But they're building something with the foundation of not agreeing on everything.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Here it is.
And then you got guys playing themselves.
Right.
Same as
permeable. You can get in it. Do whatever you want with it.
But with a rock is firm.
That's foundation. Yeah.
And what's that dude in your song? Castles made of sand.
Right.
Going to sea eventually.
Yeah, it's going to crush, man. It's going to be made public when these people that are claiming to be holy people, it's going to be made public when they fall.
Now, I got biased at first as well, because it touched the sore spots about slavery for me. You know, the Deuteronomy verses. I'm gonna be honest with you, my bubble was burst when I was 8, somebody called me a pickaninny. And it hurt my heart. It hurt my feelings, because I didn't know what it meant. I didn't know all the division, why it happened, and then you start opening up the Bible. And then their bitterness starts pouring to you, you get biased. But when now that I have brothers from all nations who believe in the word of God, it allows me to remember.
You say they called you what?
A pickaninny. I was 8 years old. I had a friend, he was German.
Yeah.
And I never could spend a night at his house. And he had a neighbor, and we were in his neighbor's yard playing. And I lived out in Reynoldsburg for a few years. I was like in the second or third grade. And he came out with a bat. He said, "Get out of my yard, you pickaninny." And I didn't know what it meant.
That's fucked up.
I didn't know what it meant. Like, it shattered me.
How old was he?
Huh? The guy was old. Like, he was like 40.
Oh, he's an old dude. But a lot of people like that, man. You know what I mean?
And they're brothers, too. They're Israelites.
Yeah, because you got a lot of Jakes that look like white people. And they're racist as hell. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
There's weeds amongst the garden, man.
Right.
There's shaft amongst the wheat.
Mexicans hate the Judah. Yeah. Issachar hates Judah. Because you reading the Old Testament, there was always the Southern Kingdom, Northern Kingdom, they was always battling each other in war, actual warfare, going hard, killing each other.
Well,
you know what I mean?
I'm going to tell you something. I edify this brother real quick.
Go ahead.
He's a listener. He's got a lot of zeal. And he's a reader. I can look at you and tell, man. Sometimes, and the Bible says be slow to speak. Based off of somebody else. No basis of experience. But, you know, and that gets exposed as well, man. Blessed assurance. We need confidence to know that we know that we know. So that we can teach the nation, man. And I see that there's brothers who will say, "I don't know." Or, "I am not sure." I said, never be so sure of what you're not so sure of. If I don't know, Jeremiah 33, verses 2 and 3. The Lord God says, "Call me, and I will show you great, unsearchable things I know it's not." And if you don't tell me, it's because I'm not supposed to know. And there's a lot of us who don't realize that there's so much we don't know yet. And that we need to be operating as a body. You know, we need to love one another. It's hard, though.
That's an old proverb. No, we don't know. That's important knowledge. That's wisdom.
And then what about the things we don't know we don't know?
Things we don't know.
Thank God for the grace, man. Like,
I mean, that's why, you know, the Lord gave different people, brothers, different spirits.
Yeah.
Some brothers are good at the Hebrew language. Some good at getting the vision. Some get, you know, got different talents.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean?
Wonderful. That's that first Corinthians chapter 10, man. We were all eyes. We were all noses. Mouths. We were all mouths.
Yeah,
we can't function. We can't function. If everybody was a cameraman, there would be nothing.
But you gotta have a cameraman.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Nobody likes to try.
They got years of experience.
Yeah.
You know, you gotta go try for a job. You gotta use references.
you got thousands of videos.
Right. He done got good on it.
Hey.
Zooming in, zooming out.
He's good.
Yeah.
Sharp.
Yeah. My brother too.
And friendship is a marathon, man. Like, we always look to find where there's error instead of finding where we agree. That exposes self exaltation, and it also exposes, was it Philippians 2 and 3,
vain contempt. So Philippians 2 and 3 says, do nothing in vain contempt. 4 says, putting others above yourself. 5 says, let this mind be that was also in Christ Jesus. Or Yeshua. Or Hemishiach. Or, you know.
It's your house shot. Now that's something I will battle with you about.
I'm thankful to God for that he didn't love me less because of what I didn't know.
Yeah, the scripts also say prove all things, too.
That's
so,
right. No, I'm with you.
Because the Lord's name is Yahweh Shai.
Every father,
Yah. Yeah, Yahweh Shai, Yahweh.
You hear the angels, man. If you have a certain ear, you can hear the spirit. You can hear the angels calling. You can hear.
That's my boy.
You know, and you should have heard Farrakhan break it down when the baby's calling on Heavenly Father. Oh, but he said the baby's be calling on Allah. Allah! Allah!
Yeah,
Farrakhan went off, man. I would love to run into him in person.
Well, Allah does mean God in Hebrew, though.
Power.
Yeah, it means power.
God. You ain't no baby calling on
Allah. Yeah, the word God just means good. In German, God is good. God, it's the same thing.
You know, and it also, I think it had Greek roots, right?
God. Well, in Greek, God is Theos. In Latin, God is Dios. But, you know.
So God was a German word at first?
The actual English word, G-O-D, that's German. English is a Germanic language.
Germanic Latin, right?
Right. So God, the way to say God in German is, it's just God or God. Good. Good is God. Yeah. It's the same word.
It's funny. He knows all languages.
And just like the word evil, the word devil has the word evil in it. You know what I mean?
But I've heard Hebraic names for him. Elion. Elohim.
Well, that's Iwalam, which is, it means the everlasting. Yeah, that's just like the everlasting. Everlasting Father.
There are people here among you that are from a different fold, right? There are people who would know things around you that won't share things because a lot of people won't receive or believe. There are, and God will activate a different testament from people. So we talk about the Quran. It says in the Quran to refer to Israel. It says in the Quran, it's Surah 2, yeah. 31 through 35.
Yeah. Israelites.
It tells them if they read their Quran, it will lead them to our instruction.
To the truth. Yeah, that's right. And it says that the two instructions, yeah. Four instructions, or something like that.
All of the people in the book.
Yeah. That's crazy.
I love you, brothers, man. Like, this has been more agreement. And even, you know what I mean? Like, anything. That's generally what we need, man. And prayer, obviously. You know.
Well, yeah. If you sell some time, you'll say something crazy.
Oh, yeah, of course. We're human.
That was all of us at one point, too, when we before the truth hit us. We was, I mean, I could imagine how foolish I was. Somebody would put a camera on me, and I would came out with that bomb.
Yeah.
I would have, I imagine them video hits.
He's been looking at me the whole time.
Waiting, man. I'm as soon as I knew.
Oh,
you know, but
now back when I first, like, when first, I said, back when I first started teaching, I was crazy as hell. Yelling at the top of my
fucking Tupperware flying at us.
Well, I mean, I still do it.
What the word do? Edify.
I
want people to hear.
Yeah, I want people to hear.
I want them to get offended or accepted, you know? I like to excite that.
The main thing we try to do now.
Right. Excite something. People understand passion. We get passionate sometimes, you know? So people take offense of a man speaking like a man. They want us to be out here speaking like homosexuals.
Let me tell you something. I was working on the bus. I came down here under the premise of purpose.
Right.
And I was talking to a friend of mine, she's German. She's a woman of God. She reads.
Right.
She reads a word. She's an avid reader.
She's a woman of God, you said?
She's a woman of God.
She didn't acknowledge the brothers.
I told you.
Let me tell you something. You don't know what God gives somebody in the message that they're giving. And where they're at today is not where they're going to stay. So, you know what I mean? This friendship is a marathon. But you also got to know when to cut people off. You know what I mean? Like, but if we can agree that salvation is salvation, let's start there. And we can disagree about stuff, that's fine. It doesn't mean we have to quarrel and fight.
We don't disagree. Yeah, we gotta come to an understanding. Everywhere you go, bro.
If we don't agree on something, we're gonna talk about it.
I mean, stupid shit like I'm a Steelers fan, they Bengal fans. I mean, that's irrelevant. You know what I'm saying? But when it comes to this truth, though, that's 100.
That's what I'm saying.
That's what it's called.
The most priority things is the gospel, the Torah, it's not the now known as the
right.
It's the most important thing.
Like, ain't nobody out here. in agreement on, you know, things like, we definitely ain't gonna be nobody out here celebrating Christmas or no shit like that.
Thank you. We in Isaiah.
Ain't gonna be nothing crazy.
We in the Word.
Let me read this real quick. This is 1 Corinthians 1:10. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai, yeah, Mashiach, that ye all speak the same thing, and that there be no divinations, divisions among you, but that ye be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. King James.
But I all think King James. 12:1, and most King James, my thought was, and this is your different brother by the mercy of God. I see you put the Hebraic, the source
Hebraic. Oh, yeah, well, I mean, yeah, because.
Bring your body a living sacrifice.
He said, because he was ready, what are you talking about? When he said Christ, he just said the Messiah instead of Christ.
Yeah, when I was reading, because I read in the Word in 12:1 of Romans, it sounded different from that perception. So, you know, even Paul talked about marking things, right? If there be a disagreement.
Yeah, it's marked.
Mark those that cause divisions among you. And mark them, and that's mark mean
scope them out.
There you go. There you go. That scope means to put a scope means put an eye on them. Scope
A. Romans 16.
Scope A. You'll
find it.
Yeah, we can read it. Bring that up.
Which one?
Romans 16. Okay. What
he got? 1 Corinthians 12.
I'll get it anyway.
All right.
1 Corinthians 12:25. That there should be no schism in the body, but that the members should have the same care one for another.
Yeah, you just quoted that scripture earlier too. Because the whole body, yeah, has got to be in unison. You know what I'm saying? We all got to be saying the same thing. We can't have him teaching that I can't be saying the Sabbath was on a Saturday. He's saying we follow the new moon. You know what I mean? We all teach the same thing. Like with the Sabbath, we all teach us to go by the new moon.
And wherever you may have a disagreement, mark it and pray that it be settled, resolved.
Well, yeah, you always got to examine yourself. You know what I'm saying? That's scripture on that. Examine yourself.
Romans 16:17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which causes divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them.
Right, because there's a new doctrine that came up amongst the brethren about people teaching about a flat earth, teaching that the earth is flat. That's what's getting hot. You got to rebuke that, you know what I'm saying? Well, you got to stamp that out.
You're right. Well, my Hebrew name is Harun Uwata Dawi, right? Father named me Uwata.
Are you part of the camp, man? Anywhere?
No. I agree. We're brothers, and I mean brothers. I haven't settled in a camp. I do know it's Babylon Falls.
No, it's now. We got to do it now. Before, we got to get out here warning people. Get them in. You know?
That's it. When the destruction comes, ain't no worse teaching after the destruction of Babylon. That's a wrap. We're going to the kingdom, sipping that fine wine.
You know, you ever think about a bowl with golf balls in it? You pour beans in it, it fills up those spaces with golf balls in it. All of us are part of that. Wherever the place that God has me,
they talking about rapture.
Wherever He wants me, wherever y'all would want me, that's where I'm gonna be in my ministry. He has you guys here where you need you to be. And I see that a lot of people have an issue with control, right? Luke 18 and 14. Where they want self-results, so they are used to trying to control instead of letting the Spirit of God govern their movements and orders.
I mean, because most people, what they really care about is being famous. They think they're going to get some bang glory being famous. Oh, I'm on YouTube. I got teaching videos. I'm the best speaker. You know what I'm saying?
Very accurate.
You gotta kill that ego.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So we are used, the whole point, the message is selflessness. You know what I mean? The Lord said He's going to sacrifice Himself for His brother. You know what I mean? You're supposed to present yourself as a living sacrifice. You know what I mean?
Let me read this real quick.
It's all about selflessness.
This is Luke 14:21. So that the servant came and showed his Lord these things. Then the master of the house, here being angry, said to his servant, go out quickly into the streets and lanes of the city and bring in hither the poor and the maimed and the halt and the blind.
Yeah, the poor and the maimed. Our people, they were all jacked up and broke. They broke down and, you know what I'm saying? Living a life of hell.
Yeah, right. Let me finish this.
Yeah.
And the servant said, Lord, it is done as thou hast commanded, and yet there is room. And the Lord said unto the servant, go out unto the highways and hedges and compel them to come in, that my house may be filled.
And that's what we do. We try to compel brothers, you know. We try to persuade them. Well, it's not up to us.
Yeah,
anyway.
It's the Lord that opens them up. We
ain't doing nothing.
That's right. You just showed up and he's doing the rest.
Yeah.
The whole thing is this. I've learned this. It's good in this way. Whereas he's showing me. I lost my train of thought.
It happens all the time. I've learned to deal with it. It just shuts you.
Shut the book, Daniel. Shut the book.
Lord, shut the spirit off all the time.
Yeah. Can I tell you this? I want to know, because I want to know you brothers. I'm going to give somebody my information. And I want to see what you guys today. So I believe it's Revelations 12 and 11. By the blood of the Lamb, we say by the word of my testimony, we overcome. What brought you here?
What do you mean?
I think it's
got us out here in spirit.
What's the reason? What happened in your life?
Nothing. It's just the spirit. Just a time for wake up and revelation.
You seek, you will find.
You keep
knocking on the door, sooner or later, it's going to go open. I just don't know who's behind that door. You know what I'm saying?
I tried to kill myself in 2010.
Right. You didn't try too hard, bro.
Right.
What you do though? Pills. Pills is usually highly effective too.
There's so many things I can tell you about this. I want to tell you
I need to get revelation
around. I heard moving around.
I was going to get the knock of scriptures and revelations for the three.
This is what I want to tell y'all, but in the future, share, man.
We're out here. That's what we're doing. We're sharing it.
Share the reason.
And we ain't charging the price for it.
The intimate moments that brought you here.
Yeah, we always do that, bro. we tell them a story a thousand times.
Yeah, we'll jump around a little bit.
We always tell the same stories over and over.
Yeah, it's always good to hear.
Yeah.
What it was like, what happened, what it's like now.
Oh, yeah, we give you the whole history.
Right.
You go watch our videos, we got the whole history right there. Yeah. We done told all the stories.
You're right.
Man, my hands will go, I should have been destroyed. I did a
dying and go for it.
Mercy triumph over judgment. Mercy.
We pay for repentance and forgiveness.
You know the Hebrew word for mercy?
We know that heat that's coming. We know that real heat that's coming. And you want to get delivered out of that heat that's coming. So every day, all day long, man, we in the spirit praying that we get forgiven for the wicked shit we were doing, man. You know, that's a humble man that can acknowledge his wickedness.
You got something you want to add, man.
It's John 3:30. He must increase, but I must decrease. He that cometh from above is above all. He that is of the earth is earthly, and speaketh of the earth. He that cometh from heaven is above all. That's what part is out here. It's decreasing, increasing, you know, it's teaching.
You know what? And, there's a few of us who know when Father's presence is right here. Abba is in the midst. You know, when we're young, when somebody paying attention to it, we act differently than when we think we're by ourselves.
All that's opposed to this. I need the internet to make my heat grab.
So a lot of times when we felt alone in life, we were never alone. We wanted to expose.
I never had that feeling. That's why I always desired to be alone, especially as a child growing up. I always desired to be alone because I didn't want to be around my brother, sister, mom, dad. I wanted to be alone because I was always spiritually talking to somebody. I didn't know who I was talking to and what, you know, but now I do. I know exactly why I was doing it.
I was always there.
Right.
It said in the Bible, Psalms, it's not retorted. You know, 27:10 says, your mother and father forsake you. I'm over the bitterness in it. So I needed to be set out, you know, into the wilderness so he can press me until in a position where I would cry out, where he can get the best of me, like, when press the olive. You know what I mean? The oil comes out, you get the best oil.
So we got because there was five that was wise and five that was foolish. You know about that, right?
Yeah, man.
So the dudes with the five that was foolish was them cats over there.
Yeah.
They walk around with lamps with no oil in them.
Dry shit.
Yeah, all dried out. And they gonna come over here trying to get some of our oil.
Looking to jack your oil. Right.
Yeah, trying to take my oil.
Right.
They can't have our oil. They be on YouTube. Yeah, they'll talk shit about you, but watch all your videos. And learn everything from it.
Thank y'all for your transparency. I appreciate your transparency.
I got a scripture. You was just talking about how lonely it is or whatever.
Right.
You know, because this is a lonely road we doing
soldier
right here.
Soldier goes back to solitary.
Yeah.
Or something,
yeah, singular.
I'm sick. Jaw broken. I'm going to find out my cousin. Same spirit's going to take me out, right? Jaw broken. Went to the fires to eat. No hungry. And there was a time where the enemy had me so deep. Right, where the father allowed it, of course, you know, he allowed it, because I allowed things to happen and I didn't follow him, you know, right? So I got trampled, man, and he brought me to a position now where my speech is hindered, like, the things are going on right now, I'm excited for it. I'm also scared for people outside of, you don't have a camp to stand in, don't have a company. I'm scared for it, man, like, I remember what it was like to not know you were under the demonic chain.
As the Lord did him like that, bro. I don't feel sorry for him one bit. Because think about it, it's the Lord's will.
Right.
The Lord, he said that, you know, two-thirds are going to perish.
That's right. The third is gathered.
I mean, I know we pray that Israel wakes up, but we smart. We can't be naive.
That's right.
I
feel
bad about the Lord. It's like when you see a prostitute. It's like when you see a prostitute on the corner. On one hand, we feel bad for the hoe. You know, she's out here, she got babies to feed. And on the other hand, she's a filthy whore.
Right. Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. You just said something, man. I heard you. You said, think about how he feels, right?
Yeah. Remember John 1 and 1? He said, I came to...
I get John 3 and 18.
And John 1, 10 through 12, man.
Hey, let me. We got a script. It's the first we talking about. Well, I just talked about how the majority of people, they're just gonna be destroyed, right? Okay, this is a lonely road we're on right here. This ain't for everybody. Matthew 7 and 13. Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. Few.
You
know what I'm saying? So I feel sorry for him on one hand, the other hand, hey.
Hey, the precept that gets close to that is in John 8, where he's talking to the Pharisees and he says,
about.
Yeah,
they saw you of your father the devil.
They wouldn't receive him. He said, I came unto my father. If you don't receive me, you don't know him.
That's right.
You don't know him.
So then they told him today was a bunch of devils.
What's up, bro?
He cursed them out. He didn't feel sorry for him right there, did he?
He's that,
Courage is New Zealand, man. He's got New Zealand.
Oh, he got
it. Courage is New Zealand.
Oh, yeah.
He's got it.
I already know he got
it. Jake
right
here.
Oh, that's your boy.
Hey, how you doing, man? You remember him?
Did we talk to him before?
No, I thought
you,
I was asking.
Oh, no. No, I just said that's your boy. He reminded me of someone on Mortal Kombat.
Shang Tsung?
Yeah, that's a Jake right there.
Yeah.
Man. That's a brother. That's a brother right there. He was, well, what's your nationality? You Chinese? I don't want to offend you like this.
Beating them knees. What did he say he was?
He said, I come from my mother.
You know, only Jake would say some smart ass shit like that.
But your dad shot you out. He shot you out.
I gotta get this guy on camera.
That's your boy, Faye Law.
Right. Exactly.
One ain't number to incubate. You just sitting in the crow. But that one, that sperm got a spirit. That's why when you shoot it out, it's swimming, it's moving, it's looking for something. You know?
And so, sperm cell. You got connected and
you
built into one.
That's Jake for you. That's a Jake.
That's a check. It's just beautiful, yeah, man. Seeing somebody from another nation that's actually you. You know, it's awesome, man. All right.
Hey, they
say, not only
the world, but they're getting recognition.
They
all around here. These people are in need. Like, these people are in need. Say that, man. Trying to reach out. They in desperate need too. You know.
Yeah, you robbed that spirit. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. It was like a dormant.
That demon was in there. When you fuck, you start. It's like you start tickling them demons, and people with demons, they start getting riled up.
Can I tell you something? That's
beautiful, man.
It's the beginning of the process of maybe him being separated from it.
Well, right, because that's part of that. It's like the exorcism. Because you got, you know what I'm saying? But not like that. You know,
that's what I do.
But you casting demons out by teaching the word. And you'll see people go nuts, bro. They start shaking, gyrating and shit.
Yeah, right. Literally slipping out.
I've seen them vomiting.
We see people spit. We see people pour their dick out, shaking it.
Yeah, pour their dick out.
We seen it all right in on camera.
Yeah, because the demons have somebody, they pull a knife out on you, a gun on you.
Because all of the media, whether we're slow or fast, that's a fast one. That happened, and it's right now happening. You know, but for some people, it takes time. You know what I mean? That slow deliverance, yeah, like a slow burn,
Israel,
man. Like,
Israel knucklehead, hard-headed, stubborn.
We talk about Israel being in the wilderness for 40 years, but there's angels have been in the flesh for 400. Charles Manson.
Charlie.
I ain't ready for that.
That's a Jake.
That's your homie.
He's been out there keeping that shit 100. All the way.
100.
I bet you he got some stories for your ass.
Right. And I would buy a couple bottles of liquor just to hear them stories too.
Hell yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And you know he got stories to tell you, man.
He probably got bodies. Did you get your boy on camera? Oh, you gotta get him.
You're on the brink of the best thing that ever happened to him. When you get that kind of zeal, that right now I got deliverance zeal, it's different than years down the line. Like, it's different. Them are people who need to be on the front row. Like, them are people who you need to put right here, like, so that they can reach people who also have a need to have the those people.
Right, we just read about that, yo. I'll get your boys on camera for them. Go ahead. We usually come, our main spots lately has been right here. We go up on campus.
Right there, close to the edge.
I like this spot better, though. It's more.
You
know, I need
it down here.
That's all I need to keep moving, because they've been tearing it in Iran too long. They're not ready to go forth into Canaan. They're still in the same mindset.
They want
to
go back to Egypt.
They want to go back.
Yeah.
So they went from Ur. They were hanging out in Ur. They go to Haran. They're still tearing, walking around the promised land. We need to walk into the promise. They want to hang out. They don't want to be approved.
It's just like the ancient Israelites, they wanted to go back to Egypt. Nowadays, they want to go back to the plantation. And they'll fight for their slave master. For them to have the right to be a slave.
The prophets were scary, man.
Yeah,
prophets coming into the city. The people were worried.
They got scared.
Yeah, you know? People was worried. And that's why them motherfuckers is not stepping over here.
Because
they will get cussed out. I will, you know.
We try to be brotherly with them. Just stuff.
Right.
I know what you mean. Like, see, they have a vain view. Some people, like people with church folk. Low-key church folk have a vain view of what's holy and what's not.
It's
philosophy.
They ain't got a clue.
Them motherfuckers get the first chance, they will jump one of us.
Oh, they would. Too.
They will, because some carnal-ass niggas, man.
But most of them cops, though. A lot of them are cops.
Yeah.
You know, spend too much time tearing for you to be able to sharpen with them. You can, if I ask them, I ask you, brother, what brought you here, ask them, they run away immediately.
Don't want to answer nothing.
So you feel that conviction and okay, I'm afraid, I'm still in the shame about my walk, how I got here, and I won't talk about it. But you walk away from me when I'm like, come on, let's talk about scripture.
You try to talk to them?
Yeah, man. They don't even deal with me. They won't even look my way. They run every time I get close to them. They be like,
say that ain't right.
Demonic force be moving.
We talk to whoever want to talk.
Got a question?
Yeah, that's why we
got a question. Because I don't have a filter. That's the reason they're afraid of me.
Yeah, because.
folks, man. And I, you know,
they looking for someone to brainwash.
Yeah.
Well,
can't brainwash this.
They looking for some young suckers who don't know nothing. They reel them in, you know.
Now we're gonna talk about some real situations here, like Crip Blood GD, right? We talk about out here, everybody has a function. All of us are actually part of a function. And everybody starts to get knowledge and start getting edified and word. And start reading and have brothers like yourself, you know, like the folks out here, brothers like yourself getting involved and being real. It's about being real first.
You gotta be real. You can't be out here being all fake, playing that Shakespearean role.
They shall not teach every man his neighbor, and every man his brother, saying, know the Lord, for all shall know me, from the least to the greatest.
Yeah,
from the
least to the greatest. And they, that's our job as people. You know what I mean?
I want to be a fire on the altar that never burns out.
Sir, hey, that's the Matthew fire, bro. You got to let your light shine. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, their light is like hidden in a cave.
What is that?
Ours is up on the mountain, so everybody can see it. Looks like that's why we right in the midst of everyone.
Looks like they was down there teaching for 10 minutes.
Yeah, they're done.
I've seen them down here preaching for booty, like Comet brothers, mm-hmm. Like these Comet dudes.
I just want money.
Oh
huh?
Man, Comet. Oh, oh, trying to get booty preaching.
Oh, you talking about just get some women?
Yeah.
Well, we ain't gonna get no women the way we teach. When you teach her, when you bring her the proper way,
yeah. you gonna get the right time.
But see, when we out here teaching, actually, when you're out here teaching, the woman's a distraction. The woman is Satan coming through trying to distract you while you're teaching. You see that big fat ass walk by? That's that temptation. You gotta block it out.
Right. That's the spirit too.
I want y'all to know this though. And you're right. Most of them you find 95% Jezebel, harlot, spirit. But I want you guys to know something. There were the Deborahs, the Rebeccas.
Well, I mean, that's very few and far between. But they out there somewhere. Where they at? I don't know where they at, but they out there somewhere. They're not over here.
You're right into some, so don't push them away.
Yeah. None of
you. We cool to everybody though. So we don't just this woman come up and see. Maybe like 6 years ago, if a woman came up here, I would have cursed her out or something. But now, I've been walking through that.
The Lord is looking for men.
If a woman got questions, we'll tell us and stuff.
Right.
But at the end of the day, you ain't going to see women out here doing the work.
Right. Revelation 21:3.
You know, I mean, just at least agreeing with
because,
the word.
Because you got a lot of women, they claim that they're down with the truth, but you never see them helping brothers.
Right.
Buying stuff, you know, for camp, cameras, clothes. They all in Nate's camp.
They in the wrong camps, right. Here you go, Revelation 21:3. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of the Most High is with men.
I got a precept for you.
If you don't mind, I'd like to pray about that. I'll just pray in silence about it. About you guys having good virtuous crowns around.
Yeah, that's going to come in the kingdom. It's going to come.
That's in the kingdom.
Yeah, that's going to come from this side.
Because Paul said, those that you have wives be as though you had none.
Right, right.
So even if you got a good woman, so-called good woman, she's still not going to profit you much. Because you got work to do. Yeah. You ain't got time to be laid up with your woman all day.
So that's what they want. They want all your time.
They want all your time. All your time. We are scared of the world. Right
time
now.
To go home and lay down. Go home and lay down.
I mean, I know that's the truth. You know, actually.
They're women that are most
important. Because usually the woman, usually a prostitute is more virtuous than a woman claiming to be a woman.
And my voice is to the sons of men.
Oh, there you go. Beautiful. Welcome to the spirit right there. So it's like we did last week. We're just cutting up the spirit of Diana.
Oh, yeah, that
you know,
yeah.
We're to the spirit. We got to fit that one.
I didn't even watch it.
Man, the Lord is not dealing with women. And then he sent us an example of some of the
some Jezebels. Remember that, man?
You know, hey, can you hold this again?
But these women,
drinking too much coffee, boy.
Man, they ain't gonna come in this side. And you may find a woman, some of us may have a wife, and she
might be cool, you know.
Yeah, right, she'd be cool. That's because she's with you, but once a new dick comes
out, it don't matter if she's like super Israelite princess.
Right, man.
Super Israelite. The chances are, if you're going to find a good woman, she might have been an ex-prostitute.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Ex-hoe.
You know what I'm saying? She done lived a hard life.
She going to bug out.
It's usually
she's going to bug out.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah.
Bug out.
But it's the women who know they Israelites that you need to stay far away from.
Worst ones.
They got your boy locked up.
Yeah.
Didn't they?
Yeah.
We could testify about your boy.
Hey.
He said he was going to make a video on it.
Bitches are crazy. Ooh. Hey, since
you're talking about Davion.
But that's his business, though. I ain't going to speak on it.
I mean, he says for education.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's for education, right? And I'm sure he don't care.
Bitches are crazy. They say they believe in the multiple wives and shit. But really, they believe don't.
No, hell no.
And they're going to tell you, they're going to try to command you to have one husband, one wife and shit. And she going
to
try to.
And then she going to try to hit you with scriptures.
Yeah. Bug the fuck
so out. You better off just getting a woman who don't know nothing.
Yeah. These women going to really bring you another wife? Right.
I'm teacher shit.
I mean, you can teach her a little something, but I mean.
Yeah, you can teach her basic shit like, bitch, wear a dress, cover your head.
Savage. Yeah, cover your ass.
Wash
up.
Wash a pussy, you know? What else can you. Don't eat pork, you know, a diet. Simple shit, you know?
The woman ain't built for all that deep, super deep knowledge.
Teach her to go out on the streets every week.
That's why I said, when you look through history, you see all the great scientists, inventors, philosophers, mathematicians. They're all men. It's all men from, you know, Aristotle to Socrates to Pythagoras to fucking Nikola Tesla.
Right, right.
You go on down the line, it's all men.
Oh, you know. The people that, right.
So he's just going
to talk about the forest military might,
friend of man.
Fighters, warriors.
All warriors.
Men. They're all men.
All men. Yeah, you going from King David to Maccabees to even Alexander. We talking about just the greatest men in history.
What happened to Mary on the Passover? Mary Magdalene and her mother, like, they was righteous women, but they wasn't, you know, they wasn't in the Passover. They was just men.
Everybody else was like, what's up? He's dying. And they were the only ones that were, like, there, like.
But their place, they knew.
The apostles thought, they were like, okay. Everything they seen, they were still doubting he was going to come back.
It's just like when you having a grown folks party, everybody's
kind of there waiting, like.
Look, it's like when you having a grown folks party, everybody was playing cards. Little kids ain't allowed up in there. Just like when the Lord and the disciples is having a big meal, they know that's for men. And the women and children ain't allowed up in there. They be like, get your ass, he's busy.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You guard this door, make sure nobody come in.
Right. Here you go. This is Job 39:17. Because the Most High have deprived her of wisdom, neither hath he imparted to her understanding.
I mean,
break that down.
I got a precept to help break it down. Ecclesiastes 7:26. I find more bitter than death the woman whose heart is snares and nets and her hands as bands. Whoso pleases God shall escape from her, but the sinner shall be taken by her. Behold, this I have found, saith the preacher, counting one by one to find out the account, which yet my soul seeketh, but I find not. One man among a thousand have I found, but a woman among all those have I not found.
A thousand women.
It's time contextual. Of course it's timeless, right?
I mean, it's worse now than then.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. Back then, a woman had some sense.
Right, right.
Yeah, they followed, we knew we as Israelites.
Yeah. They were living in a manly world then.
Yeah.
So what do you suggest for women who are trying to
get married? We ain't suggesting nothing.
Right,
just,
nothing. Nothing.
We just it's in the Lord's hands.
Right. These people ain't gonna change.
Most of them are right now looking around like with the word being edified, the word looking like this. Dogs with their tail between their legs. Instead of feeling
it's not for them.
Of feeling a part. So there's no what part do they play?
They got no part.
As far as changing Israel, they ain't playing no part. None. That's just it. That's it.
I mean, if they do, praise the Lord. I praise the Most High. But we ain't going out of our way. We ain't setting our expectations too high.
Right.
Well,
right.
You know how to get in communion with Abba right now. for the right now current revelation, like the right now revelation.
Well, we right here, right now. Yeah, right here.
I mean, when you see.
No, what I'm saying is you can talk in right now, like open up your word, but you can talk. You can directly when you close your word, go home.
You don't see none. Come up here asking questions.
No, you just do it all in your spirit, in your mind.
Ask him.
One brother out of all.
Well, I mean, we already know what we just
told you. Like the scripture you just read.
We already told you. They do, but we already told you because the men come first. And then the women, look, I got a perfect scripture. Give me Psalms 110. I'm going to show you, this is the answer right here. Because it starts with the men, all right? Because the men ain't in order, even they never be in order. The women follow after who has the power, who has the authority, who has the money. That's what they respect. If you ain't got that, they don't respect you. So that's just, you know.
It's on the top.
Yeah, Psalms 110.
The Lord said unto my Lord,
yeah.
Sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool.
Keep going.
The Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Rule thou in the midst of thy enemies. Thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power. In the beauties of holiness from the womb of the morning, thou hast the dew of thy youth.
Yeah, that's a scripture right there. In the thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power. That's when they going to fall in line. You know what I mean? But right now, we ain't worried about them. I mean, we got a woman. We love our woman. But we ain't all worried about saving the woman.
Right.
You know?
That's right. You know, that's what happens in the already trying to do that.
Well, right.
I agree with you as far as if you're an example, you're the head.
Yeah.
I'm not by any means a guy who, I'm not preaching for booty. I'm not the permit dude. So I'm not the
That's madness.
What I am saying is, you know, a virtuous crown isn't moved by the ways of the world.
Oh, yeah.
And
I mean,
there are a few tools.
Oh, we know that, but like I said, you know, we know that. We just saying.
It's just not a concern.
It really is not a.
You know, everybody got their realm of area, you know, they dealing in.
See, when she hit the fan, they going to come running to us.
Oh, get that scripture. Like he said, everything's gonna fall into place.
That's
it's
right.
Supposed to be.
Pegs
gonna like right. When the dominoes fall, the rest of them gonna fall.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Ecclesiastes 42:13. For from garments cometh a moth, and from women wickedness.
So how can you bring women to this? Because she like to pick and choose. If it sounds good, that scripture's right, she accepts it. If it don't right,
Now the devil put that one.
Yeah, sure it is. Yeah.
They always tell you that.
That's right, that's right.
But
that's
even men say that.
They're more infamous for it than we are.
Yeah. Right, here you go. This is Isaiah 4:1. And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man.
And in that day, seven women shall take a hold
conviction
of one man.
Conviction to them is hatred. If you're convicted and you don't come to correction,
well, that's just because they haven't been raised in the right. All women are supposed to be raised up from birth to a property a certain way. And they ain't been raised up
and
right.
I'm going to tell you this, I got a 5-year-old daughter. And that's the reason she's getting raised up in the way she shall go.
Yeah.
When she walks into some brothers that telling them the wrong thing, like you walk up to y'all and y'all say something wrong, I'm tearing y'all down. You know what I mean? Like, I'm tearing you down, physically or mentally. You know what I mean? Like, because I want y'all to know that. You have a daughter. Keep her close.
Bastard.
Keep your daughter in straight. As soon as they get much liberty, this is all game.
You know, all the years we've been doing this.
It's very rare.
Because all the years we've been doing this, we've seen brothers get
taken. She's only 5 years old, bro. She ain't done with woman yet.
How many times through the years, though, we've seen brothers in the truth do what we do? And we tell them about how to handle your woman. Just pretty much don't tell her a whole lot of your business. You know what I'm saying? Every time they talk, my woman, she's righteous though. She's good. She loved the Lord. And then she always ends up ruining their life.
Oh yeah.
You go to jail. I mean, we see it over and over
again. All of us
again.
Have been hurt by Jezebel's spirit.
Yeah, you know.
Obviously, I smell it on you, brothers. Everybody. All of us been hurt by it. And
I think my mom is Jezebel.
In the reincarnation.
One of them.
All of us. That's been the major violator.
That's a real demon too.
Like the major violator of all the brothers here.
But you can't be amazed by it though, you know?
You gotta expect it.
Yeah, expect it.
Yeah, I agree.
Hey, that's the old proverb. Expect the unexpected.
You know another proverb I've been thinking of recently, and I think you brothers also know this one.
What's that?
It's 26:4, right? Paraphrase, don't argue with fools or become a fool.
Oh, yeah.
And the next one says, tell a fool that he's a fool, lest he be found overwise, that he think he's right?
Yeah, that's part of that balance.
Yeah.
Because it can go both ways.
No doubt.
You know? But sometimes you got, you can't feed the fire, fuel the fire of a fool. But sometimes you gotta answer a fool foolishly. You know what I mean? It's all about balancing, you know, having wisdom. Yeah, but you know, most people say that's a contradiction, though.
The reason is because I think Spring and Arabic text translations, they don't know the proper things. Like, just they're in English language. You can't find it. It doesn't make sense in other languages. Like,
well, you do lose some for it.
It's kind of bastardized a little bit.
A lot of it.
Yeah.
It's probably Lord's broken parables.
Yeah.
They know they wasn't
going to
get it, so
he
just spoke
parable. Yeah, all right, because, hey, get that. I'll get it. Matthew 13. If you already got it, Matthew 13:9.
All right, Matthew 13:9. Who hath ears to hear, let him hear. And the disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou unto them in parables? He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given.
All right. Hey, you gotta read that again. Yeah.
He doesn't know that.
Nah, he's good. Read that.
You have.
God, I.
Yeah, this is key right here. Oh, yeah.
You have ears to hear, let him hear. And the disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou unto them in parables? He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. But to them it is not given.
That's the Lord himself, but he said to a large majority of people, he said, to them it's not given. That's why I'm speaking in parables. You know, so only a certain people going to get it. But most people, their mind ain't built spiritually to accept parables like that.
Uncircumcised ears.
Yeah, right, uncircumcised ears. And uncircumcised hearts.
And the veil of the womb, so you can hear it.
This is Romans 11:7. What then? Israel hath not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election had obtained it.
The election had obtained it.
And the rest were blind.
That shows you there's a distinction from the holy Israel to the elected Israel.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? Because Israel is all chosen, but you got that like that 144,000.
But you can't say that the elect of Israel is right now in Israel. When you're looking at people who are thinking this are.
No, of course. Hell no. You know, we already know that.
Elective Israel is being raised up like right now.
Yeah, what it is.
Speaking to the elect.
That's Esau over there.
According as it is written, like, the Most High have given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear.
Right, so the Lord put them in a deep sleep.
Until this day.
Until this day. And most of them ain't going to wake up. They're going to wake up, you know what I'm saying, in the kingdom.
Hey, Seth. Are they about to leave right now? Come here.
Hey,
oh, popular
guy.
What's that?
Isaiah 29:9. Stay yourselves and wonder. Cry ye out.
Stare.
Conviction. Stay your. Stay yourselves and wonder, cry ye out, and cry. They are drunken, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink. For Yahweh hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep, and hath closed your eyes. The prophets and your rulers, the seers, have he covered. And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I cannot, for it is sealed. The book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, read this, I pray thee, for he said, I am not learned.
Like a blanket of comfort for the spirit, the word of God.
They accept Islam, they accept
crippling
God's bullshit doctrine.
Oh, you could be a Buddhist or a Hindu. People be like, oh, really? Can you tell me more? If we start reading out that book, they'll come up like, hey, you motherfuckers!
Hebrews chapter 4, verses 8 through 12, right?
Yeah, it cuts his spirit up.
It cuts going out and going in. So when you speak it, you ain't living by it. It will expose some things.
While you at home sleeping, it's still cutting your ass off.
And that's why the Lord said that men will kill you.
Yeah.
That's why the Lord said men will kill you for my name's sake.
There you go. Here you go, Isaiah 30:9.
Ephraim.
That this is a rebellious people, lying children.
Yeah, that's our people. Hey, this is our people. Read that again. This explains our people perfectly.
That this is a rebellious people, lying children, children that will not hear the law of the Lord, which say to the seers, see not, and to the prophets, prophesy not to us right things, speak unto us smooth things.
And don't be reading out that Bible.
Right, man.
I want to hear about the love of Jesus. Just don't read the Bible.
Right. That's the reason why I would follow that scripture with blessed are those whom God corrects, so we're not despised and chastised in the Almighty. Tell them conviction means something right is going on.
Yeah.
The right thing is going on in your spirit. And it's letting you know that God, yeah, he loves you enough to show you that you're in error. It says he chastises, he chases those he loves. So if you're in error and you feel it, run towards him. And let him correct you. And there's a lot of people that need to hear those scriptures so they can realize. I'm uncomfortable with the scripture. It's a good thing because it's letting you know he loves you.
Prophesy deceits.
Boy, you got a unicycle.
Turn aside out of the path.
Oh, yeah, because that's what's popular in the churches.
It's Puerto Rican. Puerto Rican, my man.
Salah.
I don't shake hands like that.
All right, man.
That's a Jake, though. That's a Jake.
He probably still is.
You got that spirit?
We're Israelites.
Israelites.
We're the true Israelites. The people over in Israel now are not Israelites.
They're devils.
Their identity things. They stole who we are. They're not the people over in Israel. Those rats in Israel. Israelis.
Zionists. Cocksuckers. You know,
Israeli is not in the Bible.
Yes.
You know?
There's nothing in the Bible.
You got them devils.
They're Palestinian. They're Palestinian land.
My people are
Eritrean. They stole their land. Yeah.
My people are Eritrean.
Oh,
he's probably like 2 and 9 Revelation. 2 and 9.
I'll let me read it for him.
He probably loved to hear that.
Let me read it.
But you know, everybody got a natural hate for them rats, them fake Jews. Because they some evil people, man.
Yeah.
They're responsible for all the bloodshed on earth.
Yes.
You know?
And they love everybody.
They're not happy unless they kill them.
You know? They're making the security heavy on that
argument. They keep poking at them and rousing up Israel. And they don't. We can't find agreement and peace.
Islamic religion.
Brothers.
It's a beast.
That's why I hope I read.
Before everything, salam
alaikum.
It's been a beast. Well, salam is a Hebrew word.
Salam is, yes.
We're the real Hebrew.
Yes, the word of Abraham.
Abraham.
So that means it will be reconciled.
But we believe all the things.
Don't just stamp people and say that's done.
But we teach about the Son of God.
Oh, Son of God?
Son of God.
Son of God.
The son of Yahweh.
How God do you have a son? I don't understand.
It's very
That's
easy.
That's why I ask you. How God
is your father? Isa,
hold up, let me
Isa in your Quran.
Yeah, it's in Quran.
Yeah. Let me ask you a question.
Isa, I believe Abraham, I believe
Elohim. Who's coming back?
The message.
It says it in your Quran.
Can I ask you a question?
It's coming back.
Where did Muhammad?
Read Surah. Read Surah. Second Surah. 31-35, and then we get
in this.
Surah
231 in the Quran. Let me ask you a question real quick, though.
I'm sure.
No, we don't need no sirs. No sirs.
I have a Quran here.
No, we don't bring that bullshit out.
No.
Let me ask you a question.
It's not for shit, brother.
Listen.
I believe.
Let me ask you one question. Can I ask you one question?
I believe Quran. I believe all the books.
Okay. Well, I want to ask you a question, though.
Yes.
Where did Muhammad learn the Quran?
Medica.
Who taught it to him?
Gabriel.
Gabriel.
Yes, Gabriel.
Not God.
Gabriel from God.
So, but Gabriel, why didn't he just go straight to God? Why did he go through Gabriel?
Because he can't go straight.
So is Gabriel God?
You know, Gabriel is an angel.
Is an angel?
Yes.
Then why can't Jesus be an angel and be higher than the angels?
No,
he is. He's the Son of God, and Gabriel's under him. And Jesus learned straight from the Father.
We learned from Jesus. Jesus is like Adam.
Adam,
he don't have no mother, no father.
Then what? If Muhammad, so you admit.
From Allah, from God.
So you admit.
This is one only.
But you admitted Muhammad did not learn from God.
I love like Adam. Because he don't have no father.
No, Jesus is Adam. No, you're right. No, he's right.
Yes.
Jesus is like, he does that. His physical father was Joseph. Joseph and Mary had sex.
Joseph and Mary had sex?
Yeah, they had sex. Jesus has a genealogy.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created Jesus like...
He's the son of God. Listen. Jesus, the one you call Jesus, his ancient Hebrew name is Yahweh Shai.
Yeah.
Yahweh Shai learned the gospel straight from the Father. That's why this is superior. The one they call Muhammad didn't get nothing from God. He claimed an angel taught him. Don't you understand that?
Yes, I understand the angel.
But he didn't go to God, so he's not a prophet.
Muhammad is not a prophet?
He's not a prophet.
How did you know?
He's not a prophet.
This is an angel?
But the angel lied to him.
Angel learned this?
Look, I'm going to show you a scripture.
You don't say anything about Muhammad or about Masih Muhammad?
If Muhammad had such a pure doctrine, he should have got it straight from the Father, which he did not. But the Lord, Yahweh Shai, did.
He searched out like a DJ.
What did they call him?
I was trying to explain to you.
A jinn. Muhammad learned everything from a jinn.
It's the prophets, but not the Israel that's causing the problems.
One of them demons.
For Islam. Not them. They're false. We're supposed to be brothers. We have Abraham.
Pretended to be gay marriage.
Now, if you go to your family, it'll tell you. It'll tell you what we're like. It'll show you what we have agreement. It'll also lead you to who exactly the Messiah or Isa or Jesus is. It'll lead you to it.
Let me read you a scripture.
It'll tell you. It says it.
Hey, brother, let me read you a scripture. Check this out. It's Galatians 1:8. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. Now, Muhammad claimed an angel taught him a different gospel. He said, oh, the Lord, Yahweh Shai, he's not the son of God, he's just a prophet. Well, it says he's got to be accursed.
He's a prophet.
Jesus is more than a prophet. He's the son of the Most High. He is the one who teaches us all things. He's the bread of life. Look, as we said before, so now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that which ye have received, let him be accursed. And this was written 600 years before Muhammad.
Yes, before
this
Muhammad.
This is way before Muhammad.
Muhammad was lost the prophet.
Muhammad was just a...
He was lost the prophet.
Muhammad was just a military conqueror.
Like, for example,
he just wanted to conquer the earth.
Yeah,
he through force, but by the edge of the sword, he converts by the edge of the sword. Doesn't Islam convert by the sword?
No, Islam is coming. It's coming after Jesus.
Let me show you
something.
No, but Islam converts through violence. They say convert or die.
And the Jinn and Tawraz. Tawraz is coming from Moses. Angel is coming from Jesus. And the Muhammad out of Quran.
But that angel lied to Muhammad.
No, not lost to Muhammad. How do you know?
Because he taught a different gospel.
Give me bro.
He changed the story up.
It was real. The Lord sent that angel to go lie to Moses, because there's a story in the Old Testament how the Lord said, because there's like spirits in the
How do you have
world.
You have all the book same way?
People don't look at it. Be careful, man. Double-minded. If you don't know the truth, you ask for God to relay it to you, the message.
Yeah.
Right? Let me read. This is why I'm getting this. This is for you, though.
I believe yes, is
this is
Muhammad.
Ezekiel 3:8. Behold, I have made thy face strong against their face. Now, ain't nobody going to be coming up here and vomiting their doctrine all over us. We're going to come back at them all. Twice as hard. 10 times as hard. You know what I'm saying? But right now we're being
look, this right here,
diplomatic.
This is right your now. Book, not the Quran. You know? The Quran is a deception. This is the book right here. This is the book of our people, the Israelites.
That's what I'm saying. Why is a Christian have a mini box?
Because it's the history of our people through the generations.
It's the same thing.
The generations. It does not change.
We're not here in the midst of
it. It never changes. What changed?
They don't have no choice but to hear this. Or they can walk down the street.
There's no change. It's not the same.
No, we ain't.
That's because they're different languages. You know? The original Hebrew is all the same.
Right, if you've been teaching this word on the streets as long as us, that nice guy image will be fat. Yeah. It's going to evaporate out of you. You know what I'm saying? Your patience is going to run thin.
They're going to be like the Lord went up in the temple with a whip, just cracking fools.
I put my hands on pistols. I done been out here for a long time in the world. And I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to tell y'all something, man. Being out here, being broken, and breaking other people. Now, God will, if you're not gentle with bringing a soul and curse the soul.
Well, you ain't supposed to be looking for
this. Didn't happen by accident. So if your pride steps in the way of what he's trying to do.
Well, you ain't supposed to be out here looking to start shit with people.
Exactly.
You're supposed to come out here looking to edify people. But sometimes
that's what the Lord means.
If you care enough to be elevated enough to give them what God needs,
that's
what
that's what the Lord. That's the love of Jesus right there. That's right there. That's the love of Jesus.
That's what he made. Because you know what? When I was a kid, I got three sisters. I got two older sisters, right? And they used to make us sit down and learn how to braid. That's how I know the Lord, because the Lord did have sisters. So that's how he learned how to braid.
Fried things, chicken, you know? Isn't a word. We're going to talk about the flower.
I used to braid my girl's hair and everything.
Mingling with the...
I used to do all
hey, can someone else get this fucking back in source?
I used to do all that. I was young, though. I lost that art kind
of. Well, hey, I'll say another tradition of our people is the drink offering. Where you pour out a little liquor. That's a drink offering. That's in the scriptures. But you supposed to pour that out to the Most High. You ain't supposed to be pouring that out to your fallen homies. Sending up prayers for the dead. Hey, there's scriptures on that. Sorry, bro.
Get a piece of. Hey, this is Psalms. This is Psalm 78 and 49.
It's probably some swine season.
He cast.
I don't know.
I have no idea.
I ain't never even been up in there.
I never knew it was there.
He cast upon him the fierceness of his anger, wrath, and indignation, and trouble by sending evil angels among them.
That fake Gabriel going to Muhammad.
That was an evil spirit going to that nigga. Just giving him bullshit.
But ain't no angel even went to him. That was just some bullshit they made up. He had to have say an angel. He seen an angel to add legitimacy to the story. You know, because
what y'all in the cut doing?
He was so clever when they came up with that madness.
He wasn't clever enough because, like I said, if he was a straight, why didn't the Most High himself go to Muhammad? Like the Most High went straight to Moses. Damn, the Moses went right up to the top of the mountain. The Most High talk to all of Israel? You know what I'm saying? So did the Most High talk to all of Islam? Hell no. He ain't utter a single word.
They say Muhammad going to descend out of heaven with a white horse.
Man, he gonna fall out the sky and break his leg.
I know it's not gonna be by force. It's gonna be a day.
They got that out of the scriptures.
Oh yeah, that's a revelation.
You might not know today, but you will learn.
Keep some chariots. Keep some chariots. And everybody just seemed to be to reject the thing, reality.
How does Muhammad say he's got his? They say Islam is only one God. If there's only one God, then why did Muhammad learn the doctrine from some being called Gabriel? Who is this Gabriel being? This Gabriel creature? It's not God, but that's not God. Gabriel's not God. Why didn't God? Who did Moses learn from? Moses went straight to God. But Muhammad didn't go straight to God. But where did Jesus go? When Jesus, Yahweh Shai, when he got baptized in the River Jordan, the Most High came out to heavens and said, "This is my son in who I'm well pleased." He didn't send the angel and say, "Oh, my father said I'm well pleased in you." Nope, see? Islam's a great deception.
It's meant to be.
Oh, well, I'm not trying to hurt nobody. We come straight with it, bro. I want you to know the truth.
I want to know the truth also.
That's the truth, bro.
Says the Lord don't love.
How one God, he create all this thing for us, and they have a son. Why you don't have a lot of sons?
He does. Hey, hold the camera.
The father thing.
Hold on, bro.
trying to find this real quick.
I'm
about to die.
Let me find this real quick.
Oh man, my room is just messed up.
I got some meat when I find it.
Hey, the Bible says that we're the sons of God. We're all sons of God.
What's that old word? I forgot that. Originer?
Alahayim?
Nah, the father that we just looked up.
The progenitor.
Oh, yeah, the progenitor?
That's what the word father means. It don't mean just because you know, fucking jizzing and mother. Jizzing Mary and shit.
Yes. There's a scripture in the Tanakh, the Torah, Bible, as it's known today.
Y'all try to take it literal and shit, that the Lord actually had sex with somebody or something. Just because
they take it
son.
Literally.
Like, what the fuck? We brothers. I mean,
we're called the sons of brothers. God.
Yeah.
So nobody can convince.
My
I can't convince
Ace
him
missing.
Of anything that he won't believe himself. You know what I mean? Like one day he's gonna have to have his own understanding.
That's
his
understanding.
What the thing is, you don't get to choose nothing. The Lord is in control of everything. You have no choice. Whether if you believe or not, that's not your choice. You have no choice.
No, it's like we're choosing today.
Yeah. Yeah.
We don't believe in three gods. There's only one God.
There ain't no peace.
Is that stuff they teach in the church?
Yes.
Catholic church is full of shit. Oh. The Baptists are all—they're full of. To speak frankly, it's bullshit. Because they're not teaching this book. They're teaching paganism. They worship those three gods. They say God is three. The Bible don't say that.
He was very, very. Tactical, because he was afraid of losing anything. Remember, he said the
Jesus
nine. If one sheep
God.
Goes out, then he said 99 sheep back.
He's our
that's
teacher.
Mercy. So he was very. Tactical.
You know, he's the one who teaches.
And if somebody
yes,
comes
everything.
To him, he was very.
He brought the doctrine to us.
There's no God.
Well, what happened with
he's the Son of God?
I don't want to talk to at the same time, but what happened with the rich
yes,
fool?
Yes, he does have a son. We're all his son. Where did we come from? Where do we come from?
Right.
What happened to him?
From Adam.
Adam.
How relevant that is.
Who created Adam?
I'm saying, like, he's rejecting the Lord.
So I guess
if he rejects the Lord,
he's not rejecting the Lord. He's learning.
If he does come to the truth, that's good. But if he rejects the Lord, he's gone.
How well from Adam?
We have God's
wife.
I said if he comes to the truth, that'd be good. But if he's rejecting the Lord, most likely he will.
And Adam,
the Lord ain't gonna do it.
Adam is the
one. I'm with myself. Dude. I'm not going to be all.
Well, I try to break it down, try to explain to him. He's trying to.
I'm not arguing.
No, we're not arguing. Well, we just talk rough.
Yes.
We're grown men. We don't talk like
that. Yes. I guess one.
And it's probably communication barriers.
Yes, communication.
Just because they agree doesn't mean they're going to come to the truth. We've seen that many times. Dudes agree. Yeah.
Well, what I was trying to tell him, though, is that.
You're getting marked.
He's getting marked.
The one they call Jesus, he is the Son of God, okay? He is the first created being in the universe, and he created the earth. The Lord created the God, what you call Allah, Yahweh.
Yes.
He created Jesus. Jesus was the first created being. And then he and the
angels. Adam is first created.
No, he's not.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
The Bible says in the beginning, listen. The Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
Yes.
Because Jesus and the angels, or Jesus, whose Hebrew name is Yahweh Shad, him and the angels created the earth.
Jesus is coming after Moses, after Abraham, after Noah.
Bro.
He's eternal. He's immortal. He
started from Adam.
Well, hold on. Did you say...
Adam, Idris.
Did you say
no,
Jesus Jacob, came after Muhammad?
Yosef. And
No, he didn't say
and,
that.
Yes, and Ismail.
Do your prayers live.
Do you know who Melchizedek is?
We know who he is.
As well.
Do you know who Melchizedek?
That way we can spread the quarrels.
Melchizedek, king of righteousness. The king of Salem.
You gotta believe that some people
in Salem.
Jerusalem?
Yeah. No,
I'd have to break it down to you. But the one you call Jesus. He was created before the earth was created. He just came, manifested himself physically 2,000 years ago.
This is in the book? And you're,
yes, he's higher than the angels.
Oh.
He's the head of all the angels. He's, you know, but he made himself a little lower than the angels when he came to the earth. What scripture is that?
Philippians.
Yeah, yes. Philippians.
And then, hold, and then one's this Hebrews too. About. I think like Hebrews getting into how he created.
Yeah, this shit flying everywhere. Y'all get that? Go ahead.
And that was what he did. That's what made him the cornerstone. That's what made him the lamb. That's what makes him above all angels. When you read your, when you, it's in your Quran, it'll tie it to our Tanakh, to the Bible. You can start reading this as well. Start comparing the notes. Start reading. It's in Surah, 2nd Surah 31 through 35, and then come to the Word.
That's 31 through 35 for one.
It'll show you the connection to the Bible. It'll show you the connection. The
Bible?
It'll show you. It'll show you there's a connect. It'll show you the connection. It'll bridge the gap to us.
This is the most powerful book on earth right here.
I agree. But I won't. I'm not going to beat everybody with it. I want to encourage you that what you don't know today, you will learn. You will learn.
Hey, the Quran does not...
You have some solution out of it?
I don't know if it's good or not. But
help them bridge the gap. There is things God... Father has bridged the gap on purpose. There's things there that's leading them to us in their word.
Yeah.
In their word. And I didn't know that's how I met this guy from Pakistan. A lot of his family got murdered for preaching the gospel in Pakistan. Yeah. And he came to the temple like 2 months ago. And he has suffered so much, but he realized that what the truth was. And he came to the truth and he started to see. He used the faith. And then he came and he converted to me because of what he saw due to people who were practicing the Hebrew faith there. They were being murdered and persecuted. And he said, something's wrong here. There's something going on. And he looked into it. And it shows in the Quran that there is no mistake. There's no mistake that you're not God's people. But you have to know who the Son of God is in order to be reconciled. You have to be reconciled. You're going to get reconciled.
Motivational speaker.
Abba.
Yeah.
You're going to get reconciled under Abba. That's what makes the Hebrew.
But we're all the sons of God.
You know the truth. You know it in your heart.
The Most High did not have sex. It doesn't mean that he's son.
God did not have sex.
No,
listen.
It just means he created him.
Listen. Jesus' father. Jesus' father is Joseph.
See? Father.
His mother.
And son.
You gotta be spiritual.
This is one prophet.
Do you believe like Muhammad, like Abraham.
And what's that scripture say? How did they say he's the son of God, but his father's Joseph? It's been so long since I got it.
If you read the Quran, translate the Quran and read it. And read Surah Maryam.
I got the wrong.
I'm
gonna do a word search.
What's up with this? Listen.
Yes.
Jesus is affection. You know what affection is?
And it's plain as crap. My Bible's all raggedy anyway. Every time I open a page up, Revelations fly away. My Romans 8 is gone.
I love
we got your boy on defense. We got to get that scripture. We got him on the ropes.
There's no disagreement. You know, he revealed it to you.
Maybe.
It'll happen. It's just, right now, it's a seed planted.
Oh, yeah. Somebody else water.
Yeah.
Maybe.
We got him thinking, though. I got him thinking. Because that's something I always bring up to Muslims. They always say Muhammad is only one God. And, like, who did Muhammad learn everything from? An angel. Like, hold up.
Who did the angel learn everything from?
That don't make sense. I thought he was, like, a top prophet. So
even if you got revelation, just like Jacob wrestled with the angel.
Yeah.
Even if they got revelation from an angel, that happens sometimes.
The angel
came from the Father. you gotta get to the source.
But the angel that visited Muhammad was an angel named Satan.
That's right. I don't know. I can't proclaim to know exactly
what his revelation was. When you study the history of Muhammad, it was obvious he was, first of all, he was a conqueror, first and foremost. And he used his ideologies to conquer, is what he did.
Yeah, I heard.
I mean, so pretty much, there might be some bootlegging, because any wisdom is in the Quran. It was some bootlegged wisdom that they stole from the Israelites.
Well, actually, it was Israel that came up with the bullshit.
Yeah, it was Israel that came up with it.
You know what I pray as we're sharpening. All of us have a measure of things that can be fixed and can be encouraged. And I hope to see this. I'm going to see this on YouTube, wherever you guys post it, one day, because a lot happened. For real, a lot of good stuff happened. But I'm going to tell you this. More acceptance, more mercy, because that's who Jesus was. That's who, you got Yahawashi, or, you know, I call him Yeshua.
It's Yahawashi.
Yeah. Well, this is the revelation I got from the...
I was about to break it down.
From the Ruach HaKodesh, from the Holy Spirit. This revelation I got was that the names that the angels gave him, the names that Hebrews gave him, the names that, and Aramaic names, there are names that for different functions, right? You got El, right? With Eli, right?
He's Eli. Well, it's Allah. That's pronounced Allah.
Right? Or Elohim, right? Or Yahweh, right?
Yeah.
These are names for Father. Right? So for different
functions. Yeah, there's a title.
Yeah, for different functions.
But right? He says he got a name.
No, Roy means he sees.
Because the scripture said, whoever shall call
Elohim
my
name. Elohim means he is all things. He is all things.
Like if I call you...
Yahweh means I am.
It means he is.
He is.
Means he to
we
be.
Don't say I am.
I am, sure? Would be a higher. Yeah, I am's a higher.
Yahweh is.
Yahweh
is to come, right?
Because the word Yah in Hebrew, Yah, is a prefix.
Yeah.
It means he. Like Yahweh Shai. Yah means he. Yahweh Shai means save. So Yahweh Shai means he's the savior.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like God's name means he is. Or he's everything. You know. So, but that's because when you refer to the Most High, you don't call him I. Say I am. You don't say I am.
The great I am.
You say he is.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because then if you say I am, you're talking about yourself. So you call him he is. He's Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
You know, because you got a lot of people bugged out on calling the Most High Ahaya. What's that group? GOCC?
Yeah.
They perverting the gospel. They teaching all kind of crazy stuff.
Again, you know, whereas if you're wrong in some sort of error, everybody has a little error that needs to be corrected.
Well, that's definitely true.
So what you have to justify these wicked motherfuckers, man. Fuck them.
What I'm saying, that's not accurate at all.
Don't
make excuses. I have mercy.
Yeah.